Hi, my name is Gala. I'm Looker Studio expert. And today we will talk about one of my templates. It is Plan and Fact Spending Trajectory LITE template. I have a full dashboard with more complex charts and more powerful one. And this is super easy LITE template. It's short and easy to use. Let's check what we have here. We have title with logo and title. we have a header with logo and title. Then we have section where you can set up your daily budget for one ads platform and the daily budget for the second ads platform. And you have date range picker. I wrote Facebook ads and Microsoft ads, but could be Google, could be Twitter, any ads platform that you really use on your project. Here we have some charts. Here we have total budget. It is summary. It is monthly budget. I mean, if you have here, you can type here €1 per day. In this case, your Facebook ads monthly budget will be €31. If you write here zero, your Facebook budget will be zero. Let's change to zero to 10, just to see how does it work. We have 310. The same for Microsoft, you can change it to one. And total budget will be, you can see, summary of this monthly budget. So here we set up daily budget, and here we have monthly budget. You change it, and January is not finished, but almost finished. Anyway, and we have current spend. Current spend we pull from Google Sheets. You can add your daily spend for Google Sheets, and here you will have how much money did you spend already in January. This is the total spend percentage. Okay, we spent like, in this 10 and 10, we kind of had €620 per month, but we spent 8,000, so it's not nice. Let's change it. Let's change it to 200, and here it will be 100. Let's imagine that we have 200 for Facebook and €100 per day for Microsoft ads. In this case, our total budget will be 9,300. We already spent this amount of money, and when we divide this amount of money by total budget, we will get 93%. So, till today, we spent 93% of our total budget that we had per month. But we can see that Facebook ads, it's more than 100%, so we overspend it. And for Microsoft ads, we underspend it. So we can, okay, today's 30th of January, probably you don't have too much time to manage it. But if today's 15th of January, you can still fix your budget and you have control of how much did you spend already. And two next columns, super nice, it is spend forecast. So it means, so how much money you will spend if you continue to spend it as today. If we continue to spend as we do it till today, during January, we will spend this amount of money, that less than our total budget. But for Facebook, we will overspend, and for Microsoft, we will underspend 1,000. And this is percentage of this number, total spend forecast, divided by total budget. So in total, if we continue to spend as we do it right now, we will underspend 4%, but by platforms, this is not nice. We didn't split our budget nice between platforms, I would say that. So it's super easy. Budget you can change manually. Cost you have in Google Sheets. And this is a trajectory chart, total trajectory. Facebook ads and Microsoft ad trajectory. That is it. Super easy dashboard. But in 2 seconds, you can understand like how is it your budget KPIs is going on, like underspending, overspending, or you're good. So that is it. And here we have three lines. We have green line total ad spend, and this is a green line. Okay, let's check on Microsoft, for example, because yeah, these charts are the same. Just in Microsoft, it's more obvious. This green line, it is Microsoft spend. We can see how our spend is going on. Then this tiny green line, it is our trajectory. It is our trend line, how our spend's going on. Then we have pink line, it is plan. So we should be here, but we're still here. On Facebook, we should be here, but we are higher than we should. And this gray line, it is period limit. So this is our maximum, this is our monthly budget, that how much did we have for this period of time. Yeah, this chart is basically the same. So we can see picture super clear and understand our current position, and we can see where we are going if we continue to spend this money. So if you like this template, and probably if you work with paid ads, you like it, I can explain you how can you get it. This template, I have my template store. I launched it recently. You can find it on my website. You have here template store, or if you scroll down, you can hear Looker Studio template store, or even several templates you can find here. I did it for €5 because, yeah, it cost this price for this dashboard much more than €5. I just want to use this simple dashboard as an example how template store works. Because €5, it is kind of 2 cups of coffee, or depend where do you live, maybe even 1 cup of coffee. So it's cheap, and it's something that you don't care about this money, but you can see on this example how my templates work. If you like it, you go to template store, go to add to basket. As process is super easy, you can go to, when I record video, sometimes it's a bit slow. You can add this template to basket. You can go to template store and find here template link. We already added this to basket, I think so. Yeah, we can go view basket. We have this button. Quantity one, price five, subtotal €5. Perfect. Then this process is super easy. I think you can do checkout by yourself. You don't need it. You don't need my explanation for this process. It's a regular online store, so you just add your data, your card number, and that is it. But what is happening when you pay? When you pay for template, you will get 2 files. First of all, you will have Google Sheets, copy of this Google Sheets document that I use for current template. For current template, I use only current spend data. So in Google Sheets here, because budget we add here manually in Looker Studio level. So in this template, you will have 3 tabs. Here you will have some instructions how to use this template, some tabs overview. If it is yellow, it means some actions required. In this case, it means that please change my test random data to your real project data. And this is on a query ads tab, this tab. So you just change dates and your real cost. Here are some notes as well. So if you want to edit manually, or if you want to use some add-ons to pull data automatically, it's up to you. If you have questions about it, let me know. I can send you a link for my videos with some explanation how to pull cost. Or yeah, I can record new videos if you have something. If you have questions that I didn't answer yet. Then we have second tab that calls LS Total Ads. And this tab we connect to Looker Studio. Yeah, it's super easy, minimum formulas, because this report is super easy. When you buy more complex templates, you have more tabs and you have more complex formulas. So this is a really simple example to understand how this work, this process work. So first of all, you have this Google Sheets and you will receive some invitation to be an owner of this Google Sheets. You should accept this invitation, remove my account, Gaille Reports account, from this Google Sheets, that your data will be saved. If you don't do it, I will remove myself by my own, don't worry. And the second link that you will receive this Looker Studio link. This link means that this link allows you to copy dashboard. And here we will have edit and share button. You click here, edit and share button. You will have some settings here. What should you do in these settings? Actually nothing, because I will link your new dashboard to your new Google Sheets that you will receive to copy. So your link to Google Data Studio, to Looker Studio dashboard, will be linked to your Google Sheets. You just click and add to report. That is it. I don't understand what does it work. Yeah. Acknowledge and save. Google Sheets, add to the report. Oh, sorry, it took time. That is it. Just click edit and you have this dashboard. You have this dashboard, we connected to your Google Sheets account. What I recommend you to do, I recommend you to add your logo here. You can do it here, image, just add your logo. You can change title, and what I recommend you to do else, it is go to theme and layout, click to customize. And here I have my colors, my settings. Just change colors in this palette and change link colors. And for example, let's do some random color. I don't know. I want to change my green to purple, for example. And yeah, you can see that all elements in the dashboard where I used this color will change their colors. So theme and layout, change your colors. And that is it. And change data in Google Sheets to your own data. So your dashboard is ready. You can view it. You can copy, refresh. You can send this link to your clients, to your boss, or use it for yourself. So hope it was easy. Hope you like it. And let me know what do you think about all this stuff and about this template. Yeah.